Welcome to your English class. Today we have to start another poem, which is actually a part of your syllabus and which is a very heart-touching, a morally good and very inspiring type of poem. So it can give you a belief into God, into supreme being, and you can say that it feels like we too have undergone this type of the situations many a times in our life. Now, before starting, as usual, let us start the introduction of the poet. Her name is the name of the poem is Footprints in the Sand by Mary Stevenson. Mary Stevenson, born in 1896 and died in the year 1985. She was born in Scotland, but she was being raised in Australia. That's why it is written as a Scottish born Australian. And then she, in the Second World War, she has become a commandant of Voluntary Aid Detachment number 750. That means she has worked as an activist. She was not only a poet but a very good social worker, you can say. As an activist, she always be ready to participate wherever there is a need for her to give her services. She got many awards because of her services for the society. One of the awards she got from the Red Cross. Red Cross is an international organization, so they have given her the award for her continuous services and for her selfless services. So that was not an easy task to get the award, and that too especially from the Red Cross. One award she has got from that, and many other awards she has got from the other institutions, other organizations, from wherever they have recognized her services. And she was more an activist than a poet. As in the earlier classes also I said that poets are not made, they are born. Everybody cannot do the poetry. And sometimes we don't see the thing as the poet can see. We just have a superficial look. Like if suppose I can say that this is a pen for me. Obviously you also can say that this is a marker. But few of the people can start writing a poetry onto that by saying that what is the, like how delicate the color, the presentation of this marker is, how the ink can express our feelings and emotions, all these things. This is not for the ordinary people to write down. The poets are born. So she was, though she has a lot of sympathy towards the society, and that's why maybe because she is more sensitive, she has become a poet for herself, and she has written many of the poems which are very good, but more she was an activist. Now come to the background of the poem. In our life we have ups and downs, struggles, happiness, sadness, sorrows, joys. There are so many sayings. I think you are also getting very acquainted because of the internet and so-called Insta, Facebook, to all whatever it is you have, all the social media platforms are giving all the sayings and all the many posts are there which are related to morals, etiquettes and all. So those of the time of the Socrates, Aristotle and those people, whatever they have said, Einstein, many people's, now it is getting out and many people are making the post onto that, they are creating the images into that, and you are getting aware of that. So sometimes we should be thankful to social media that we are getting aware of so many good sayings by the people, like Gautama Buddha sayings are there, Swami Vivekananda's are there, which are very good sayings, and we are getting familiar to them. So some of the sayings are like that, whenever you, unless and until you experience sadness, you never appreciate the happiness. Is it true or not? Of course it is true. Because if, unless, like if you get any type of the sadness, whatever in your age, okay, related to like getting a little bit less marks into the examination can create sadness for you. Not getting the dress of your own choice can make you sad. Not getting the food which you like to eat, that can make you sad. You can say petty problems are there, petty things are there in the life which can make us sad. But sometimes exactly opposite can also happen. Some petty things, petty you can say situations can give you happiness, a lot of happiness. A sudden surprise gift from your friend, or a birthday wish from someone you never expected. You are some far relative who was remembering you at the time of birthday and wishing you sharp 12. You'd be like, how they can remember? How can they remember me on that day? And you feel excited, elated, very much happy. With single phone call, a single message, a smallest gift from your friend can make you so much happy. That is not the message, the gift, and the, you can say, the amount what they have spent. It is the feeling behind that which makes you happy. The same way, if we don't experience any sadness, any sorrow in our life, how can we enjoy our happiness, or you can say the excitement, the surprises? How can we enjoy? So we need both the things for the life. I think these balance the life. This actually balance the life for us. We never get proud if we don't have, if we have a sadness and all, we cannot get proud. If we have continuous happiness, we forgot to be thankful to the God. We never remember God if we are in trouble, because we never face the troubles. If we face the troubles, then we can remember the God. So it is being said, many Hindi dohas are there where Kabir, Rahim, they have said a lot of things about that. They said, like, remember God in both the times, when you are sad as well as when you are happy. There is a need to, because during happiness you should be thankful because you are happy, grateful, and during sadness you have to remember God to help you out, to take out from this trouble without any harm. So that is the human nature. We are dependent on God. We believe in God. Those people, those who don't believe in God, they are known as the atheists. Are the people, those who never believe in God. These are the one that, but after not believing in God also, they don't believe in any God, not a single religion. They don't follow any religion. So if they are not believing in God, they are not believing in any religion, but still they believe that nature is the one who is healing us. They depend on nature, or they depend on ancestors. Something could be there. Like in Japan, they believe that their ancestors are responsible for whatever the happiness and sadness they are getting into their life. Worshipping the ancestors, that is Shintoism, that is the religion they follow, Shintoism, which believes in worshipping the ancestors, great-grandfathers. So that every person, either believing in ancestors, either believing in nature, anywhere, whatever they are believing, they definitely get dependent on some or the other one. If you are a theist, not atheist, theist, exactly opposite to that. If you are a theist, means you are believing in God. If you are theist, then definitely you believe in God. Whatever religion you are belonging, you definitely believe in one different, in one God or different powers. The power which can make you submit your own will and wish to Him. So here is that. Now, before this poem is actually, you can say the poet has written her own experiences, and she has mentioned her own dream in the poem. So we'll go ahead with the explanation. Now the poem starts with, one night I dreamed a dream. Who? Poet. One night I, even see a poet, I dreamed a dream. That means she saw one dream. As I was walking along the beach with my lord. As I was walking along the beach with my lord. Here it doesn't mean that she has seen the god walking along. She actually felt the god along with her. Like it is about the situations in her life. Sometimes we don't feel all alone. We feel that okay, God is with us. The same feeling she got in her dream. I was walking along the beach with my lord. Across the dark sky flashed scenes from my life. Because it was in the night, she was getting the dream and she was getting the night itself in the dream. She has seen the black sky, and in the black sky, within moments, she is getting the flashing of the scenes, like flashback. So suddenly she saw the scenes in her life. Means whatever it had happened in her life, she was getting in front of her. For each scene, I noticed two sets of footprints in the sand. She was walking on the beach in the sand, and in front of her, when she looked upside, she saw in the sky, suddenly the scenes from her life are visible to her. When she was seeing that, she saw, whenever she saw any scene, when she is looking down, she saw two footprints in the sand. She was finding that always God is with her. One belonging to me and one to my Lord. Two sets means one set is of herself and the other one is of the God. After the last scene of my life flashed before me. Now the last scene, till how much life she has spent. By the time she was actually watching the dream or seeing the dream, she has seen that last scene she saw. After the last scene of my life flash, it was not about death, it was till the life whatever she has spent. I looked back at the footprints in the sand. From there the scene, she is looking back to the sand where she wanted to find out the sets of the footprints. I noticed that at many times along the path of my life. So what she noticed along the path of my life, of her life, many times she found something. What? Especially at the very lowest and saddest times, the sorrowful times, the times when she was very unhappy, the times when she was feeling very much low. It happens with everybody. As I said, ups and downs. So in the downs of life, the times when she was very much down, when she was facing the troubles, there was only one set of footprints. She found only one set of footprints. Every time she was getting the two sets, and this time she got only one set of footprints. So she was surprised. Have you understood till here? Like in the first set stanza, she said that she saw in the dream that God is walking along with him on the sand, on the beach, in the sand. And while they were walking, she has seen the different scenes of her life, whatever it had happened in her life. And always she saw two sets of footprints. One is of herself and the other one is of God. The next, what happened in the second stanza? She said that at the last scene of my life, when it flashed in front of her, she has noticed that many times whenever she was unhappy, whenever she was feeling sad, those times she saw only one set of the footprints instead of two. So a little bit she was, you can say, disappointed and surprised. Now what had happened in the next stanzas of the poem, we'll try to complete in the coming up class. By the time, take care, have a nice day.